In today's video, we'll talk about how to ace that marketing job interview that you have. You went through the stress of creating your resume, your cover letter, doing the applications, and now, finally, you have the opportunity to have that interview, to introduce yourself, to learn more about the role, and to see if that opportunity and if that company is actually a good fit for you. Good job on getting the interview. Now let's get that foot through the door. For me, acing an interview consists of three main steps: the preparation, the interview, and the follow-up. So in today's video, I will talk you through how I would prepare for a marketing job interview today. If I had that interview, maybe tomorrow, next week, how I would prepare, how I would do my research, how I would prepare myself for the common questions that I would likely get asked in the interview, and also how I would follow up after the interview. And keep in mind that the information I share will be more so for a generalist marketing job interview, and I'm not going to go into the details of each specialization, obviously, because the questions could change depending on the specific role that you're interviewing for. So you can think of this as a more generalist digital marketing job interview. But hey, if we're just meeting, my name is Elif. I'm a marketing strategist, educator, and content creator, and I make weekly videos on this channel around the topics of marketing and marketing careers. So if those are interesting to you, and if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing for more videos like this one. Grab your coffees and let's have a chat. So I'll start with the preparation. For me, preparation is a three-level thing. Number one, I study the role very carefully. I take a look at the keywords, the descriptions used, the responsibilities mentioned in the job description that I applied to. I know that when you applied, you did read through it, but I want you to read through it once again before going into that job interview, because you want to pay attention to the keywords that they use. And I'm not saying this because I want you to use those keywords without meaning and just because they've mentioned it, but I want you to pay attention so that you can match how you talk about your skills and experience using those keywords, and if there's anything that they were specifically maybe looking for, and you can highlight that when you're talking about your past experience. Number two is doing research about the company itself. Read the news, read their LinkedIn company page, stalk the team on LinkedIn. I know that's a weird suggestion, but that's something I do, and that's been very helpful for me because that's how I know about the size of the team. If I'm obviously going for a marketing job interview, I can see how many people there are in the marketing team, how they create posts about the company they're working for is very, very important for me because that gives me a sense of how they value the company they are working in and if it looks like it's a good match for me as well. So read the news, find out about their competition, be knowledgeable about the industry that company is in and how that company is performing within its niche. And finally, the third phase of the preparation is doing a marketing audit. And I never go into a marketing interview without doing this step. Sometimes I do it more extensively, depends on the company, and obviously depends on the type of role that I'm interviewing for. So if it's a more senior role, if it's a more specific role where I'm going to be interviewed for, let's say marketing automation, for example, or demand generation, there's definitely more effort that I would put in to prepare myself for this phase. But overall, I'd never go into a marketing interview without doing a marketing or website audit. And one more thing with the marketing audit, when I'm doing this, I want to make an observation about the successes as well as the gaps that I see in their processes and systems. If there's any suggestion, any contribution that I can make to fill that gap and to make it better, then I make sure to bring that up in the conversation. And I feel that always kind of gives me an extra score when I talk about that in the interview. Some of the high-level things that I want to look at are the types of posts published by the company, the platforms used, their website, their emails, their lead generation systems, their content types, and all of that. And if you want to hear more about how I do the content audit, there's a video on the channel that I will put over here and link in the description box below. So if you want to learn more about how to do a content audit for a company, whether that's for an interview or whether that's after you are hired and you want to impress the team, obviously, if that's a part of your job. So if you're interested in doing that, check out that video for more information on the content audit. And now let's skip to the actual interview step. Okay, now let's talk about the interview itself. And what I want to do with this one is to talk you through the most common questions that you'll likely hear in a marketing job interview. So number one thing that you're gonna get asked, and don't be surprised by any of these questions, because these are kind of the baseline questions that you will get in the interviews. Number one is, tell us about yourself. And for this one, I want you to prepare in advance and have kind of like a mission statement or an elevator pitch, whatever you want to call it, but you need to have a few sentences prepared in your mind about how you want to communicate your experiences and how you want to position yourself. So think about, you know, kind of your mission statement or maybe your LinkedIn bio. And this is also the section where you want to integrate those keywords that they've used in the job description to how you explain yourself, how you talk about yourself and your experience. So if there was any specific things that they were looking for in the description, then this is the chance to blend those keywords into your elevator pitch. Another very common question you'll get asked is, why us? Why did you choose this company and this role? And for this one, you need to find out, you need to ask yourself why you are passionate about that company. Are you passionate about that company, first of all? And if not, did you do a lot of research to maybe identify with some key points? Maybe you really like their culture. Maybe you're really interested in the growth opportunities, or you're interested in that industry or a specific product that they've launched, and that's something you're really personally interested in, and that's why you want to be a part of that team. These are all just examples, but it's really important for you to find out your why and know your why before you go into the interview, because you are likely going to be asked that question of why us and why this role. Next, we're moving to failures and successes in your previous roles, experience. I mean, these are staples of an interview, so you absolutely have to be prepared for these. A question you'll likely get is, tell us about a time when you failed as a marketing team or individually, but tell us about a failure. And the reason why this question is asked is because they want to see your attitude when things go wrong. Obviously, the expectation is to hear you identify the problem, your reaction wasn't all negative and dramatic, and you realize what had to be done, you took the action, and you arrived at a resolution. One technique that I picked up from HR professionals is called the STAR technique, and the STAR stands for situation, task, action, and result. So within the situation, you identify what is going on, why it's failing, you identify the situation you're in. Next step is the task, so you determine what has to be done. Number three is you take action to improve it or to change it or to stop whatever you're doing. And number four is the result, so moving forward, what will you do differently and were you able to turn things around? What was the result of that failed project, failed initiative? And next up is talking about your success. Tell us about the biggest success you've had in your career so far. Here you're expected to talk about something you're proud of. So think of this question in advance before going into the interview, so you already know what your biggest success is, or the success that you want to talk about in the interview, because you might obviously have multiple successes. So just make sure that you have something in your mind before you go in, so you're not dumbfounded and you don't have to kind of spend a few minutes to think about your biggest success. Next question is, tell us about a situation where you faced with a problem and how you resolved it. Sometimes this is specifically asked in terms of a disagreement with a team or within the team, or with a client, and how you resolved it. So this is a little different than the failure question, because failure is more like you were working on a marketing campaign or a marketing project and the whole project failed or something of that sort. So make sure that the answers you give to that one and this one are different. The reason for asking this question is because they want to see how you react and how your behavior is when you're facing a challenge, when you're in an environment of disagreement, and how solution-oriented you are. What are the steps that you take to resolve that situation? And if you turn that into a drama, or if you actually start taking steps to move forward. So this is what the interviewer is looking for. So again, something to think about before you head into that conversation. Also, when you're talking about failures and successes, if there is something that you would do differently, this could come as an additional question or just as a part of the natural conversation that you're having. But also think about what you would do differently to change that failure or failed project into a success, and pinpointing the reason that project failed or what went wrong and what you would do differently if you had a second chance. That's a great way to switch the conversation into a positive note. Next up is strengths and weaknesses, and you're absolutely gonna have to talk about this. So again, be prepared. Think about strengths that are relevant to this role. An example could be that you're interviewing for a 100% remote role, and maybe your strength is that you work really well with minimum supervision and individually. So that could be the strength that fits really well given the pandemic circumstances, or it could be something else. Think about a strength that's relevant for that role. For the weakness as well, don't pick something that's very irrelevant, like I'm a very picky eater. Obviously, that's not relevant to your careers. So pick something that's relevant and that you know how to kind of improve or work on. For example, it could be that you're a multitasker, and the disadvantage of multitasking may be that you work simultaneously on different things, and this in the past has shown you that you may sometimes miss out on deadlines. And after realizing this, maybe you took XYZ actions. So you also want to mention the things that you're doing to improve on this weakness. All right, so you will likely also hear this question. If I was interviewing, I would absolutely ask this question. Tell us about the marketing technology you've used and are familiar with. And I want you to get specific here. I don't want you to just talk about, oh, I use social media channels and I write blogs. That's not necessarily what we are looking for. So make sure you get specific about the technology that you have experience with. And if there's anything maybe that you're taking a certification, taking a course about, talk about that as well. Maybe you're very interested in learning how to use Marketo and you're maybe halfway through the certification program that Marketo has. So let's make up something. Maybe you've worked with Databox in the past, and for business analytics, you realize that Databox was really making your life easier at this agency. And now with this agency that's not using any business analytics platforms or doing their marketing analytics very manually. So you can go ahead and talk about how you can leverage Databox here if you were hired, and how that could help you to save time and also improve the customer satisfaction when it comes to client reporting. And a quick tip here is that whenever I talk about the technology that I'm familiar with, I always follow up with asking them what they currently use, what their tech stack looks like. And obviously I want to get familiar with what they're using. If it's new to me, I want to know what it is, if I need to learn something new. And I can think about that in terms of my 30, 60, 90 day plan, which is the next question that I want to talk about. It is, what would be your 30, 60, 90 day plan, or maybe a 1 year plan? The timeline could change, but I want you to think about the initial actions or initial things that you would look at if you are hired in that company. I'm not going to go into the details of how you should structure your plan in this video, but there is actually another video on the channel, which I just remembered I had, and I believe it's called What to Do in the First 90 Days of Your Marketing Job. I may be mistaken with the title, but I do have a video of how to kind of create your action plan when you are hired for that job. Again, the video is linked here and in the description box below. So check that out if you want to get inspired about your action plan. A few more questions, and these are definitely going to come up. Why do you want to leave your current job if you're currently working in somewhere that is? Why do you want to leave your current job and current company? So think about this, have a smart but short answer to this one. Next up is salary expectations. And again, this is a question you absolutely need to prepare before heading into that interview and to have an idea about the salary expectations. Do your research, go to Glassdoor, go to LinkedIn, look at the average salaries in the city that this company is based in, look at the average salaries in that industry of that similar company size. So there's many factors that go into calculating a reasonable salary expectation, but make sure that you did your research and you're prepared before talking about it, because you don't want to say something and then regret it because it was too low, or you lost that job opportunity because of a very high unrealistic expectation. So come up with a range that's reasonable, realistic, and also matches your expectation, because you don't want to say something that's too low and then be very unhappy with that job because of that salary. And I'll be saying this for the third time in this video already, but there's a video that's very, very detailed about how to come up with your salary expectation, where I talk about digital marketing salaries and how to do your research to come up with that expectation. Again, if you're new to this topic, if you don't know where to stand in terms of the salary, then I highly suggest that you check out that video or go ahead and do your individual research, but make sure that you're equipped to answer this properly. And the final tip about the interview phase is go into the interview with a couple of questions prepared. So I'm gonna say between 3 to 5 questions, and this is going to show that you actually prepared for the interview, you did your homework, you did your research. Couple of questions that I took notes here are maybe you read in the news that they were recently acquired by a company. Ask what this will mean for the organization. What are some changes that will reflect to the marketing team? This is going to show that you did your research, you're reading the news about the company, and you know, you're aware that this could likely impact the marketing team and how the organization is structured. So that's one example. Another one I have is perhaps you did that website or social media audit that I suggested, and you identified some gaps with the campaigns and tools this company is using. Ask about the tools. It will show that you paid attention and that you know what you're talking about. And finally, another example is, what are some major marketing events or product launches that are coming up this year or this quarter? So these are just to get you inspired, but I highly suggest that you go into the interview with your questions in hand. And finally, stage 3 is the follow-up, and I absolutely don't want you to skip this one. I personally never ever skip the follow-up, and I think it's a game changer, and I know that other HR professionals also talk about this as a game changer too. So I want you to know how to do a follow-up as well. My little tactic with the follow-up email is I obviously want to thank the interviewer for their time, and I always make sure that I kind of add this personal note, maybe a question that I had remaining from the interview, maybe something that I remembered later on. But I want to not only just say thank you for your time, but I want to add something else to that conversation, whether it's a more personal note, maybe we talked about a movie that they really like, or I wanted to suggest something to them, or I wanted to share a link to follow up with an example that I mentioned, talked about during the conversation. But I want to always add a thank you note and some personal note or a question, and always keep it short and on a positive note. And that's all I wanna talk about the follow-up in this video. If you're interested in hearing more about how I do follow-ups, what is a good follow-up strategy, or if you want me to elaborate on any of the other pieces that we talked about in this video so far, let me know in the comments and I will consider making another video. But I just remembered once again, this is gonna be the fourth time, but there is a video on my channel about a great follow-up example that could get you inspired on how to do your next follow-up after your next interview. So again, it will be linked here and in the description box below. Check that out if you need some inspiration on the follow-up email. If not, there are so many templates that you can refer to online and find online. So do your research, be really prepared. Preparation is definitely half of the success, if not more. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for being here as always. And if you like the video, please don't forget to hit the like button and share with your friends and network. And I will see you here next week. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.